In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. بسم الآب والابن والروح القدس تحل علينا نعمة الله وبركته من الآن وإلى الأبد أمين. We are in the last Sunday of the Coptic year. And the message is clear and the church is very faithful. كنيستنا أمينة. The church is giving us like a very clear message. Watch and pray. اسهروا وصلوا. Because it is at the door. All the reading today about the Lord Jesus, and he gave us many, many signs of his second coming. Said al-Masih, iddana many, many signs. I just want to share with you some of these signs. But before going to the gospel, let us see how St. Paul, because we are at the end of the Coptic year and the beginning of the new Coptic year, for he is giving us a wish for the Coptic, new Coptic year. Qudis Paulus fi Risala bta'tu naharda to the Thessalonian church, he gave like the wish for the Coptic year. Shuf el biqul ايه, حاجة جميلة قوي. Shuf di. الرب ينميكم ويزيدكم في المحبة بعضكم لبعض وللجميع. May the Lord make you increase and abound in love to one another and to all, just as we do to you, so that he may establish your hearts blameless in holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. بيقول الرب ينميكم ويزيدكم في المحبة بعضكم لبعض لثبات قلوبكم بلا لوم في الطهارة أمام الله وأبينا at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So he said, my wish to you by the end of this Coptic year and the beginning of the new Coptic year, to be ready and to be pure, to be enlightened. So at the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, you will be filled with all holiness and blameless. I hope so. I hope for myself and for all of you at the second coming of the Lord to be ready, to be blameless, to be steadfast in faith, so that he may establish your heart blameless in holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So while we are celebrating the end of the Coptic year and we are remembering the second coming of the Lord, the wish of St. Paul to every one of us, he said, I am praying that you may, the Lord, establish your heart blameless before God the Father at the coming of our Lord. How can we do that? How can we reach this wish? Saint Jacob Saint gave us like a direction to accomplish and to achieve this goal. He said, draw near to God and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinner. Purify your heart, you double mind. There is a practical way. We have to take some steps to achieve this wish. He said, you have to come close to God. Sometimes we may come close to ourselves, come close to each other, come close to a community, come close to a Coptic environment, come close to some social activities in the church, but we are not close to God, not close to the church itself. So the direction is, draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. In the book of Acts, the church is giving us today an example of Saint Barnabas. Saint Barnabas, he was one of the disciples, and he applied this verse practically in his own life. When the church was under attack in Jerusalem, persecuted, so all the Christians, they spread over, and they reached it till Antioch, and they established the first church in Antioch. The church in Jerusalem, they need someone to be faithful enough to send him to Antioch to give them like a report. How was the church was there? So do we continue establishing new churches, or is that enough? Is that a good idea or a bad idea? They need someone wise and have the gift of discernment. لما ابتدت الكنيسة في أورشليم علشان حصل الاضطهاد بتاع استفانوس، فالكنيسة اتسبريد يعني اتفرقت، وراحوا لغاية عملوا كنيسة جديدة في أنطاكيا. شوف بيقول ايه: The hand of the Lord was with them and a great number believed and turned to the Lord. Then news of these things came to the ears of the church in Jerusalem. They sent Barnabas to go as far as Antioch. They sent Barnabas. Barnabas, when he came, had seen the grace of God. He was glad and encouraged them all that with purpose of heart they should continue. Barnabas, he is the one. Because of him, now we are Christians. Can you imagine that? Because Barnabas, when he reported to the church of Jerusalem, he said, they are doing great. We have to bless them. We have to support them. And because of that, churches started to be established and started to spread all over the whole world. So we need many like Barnabas these days. شوف يقول لك كان برنابا يعز الجميع أن يثبت الرب. Why Barnabas was this style of men? For he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and of faith, and a great many people were added to the Lord. So let us summarize what we said. Saint Paul, in his epistle to the Thessalonians, he wished that at the second coming of the Lord, that we have pure heart, blameless before the Father. And he said, to achieve this, you have to come close to God, not close to a system, not close to a community, but close to him. And like an example he gave us, like Barnabas, and how because of Barnabas, because he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit, the church used him to establish many churches all over the whole world. Now let us go to the serious message that we received today. To understand this teaching of the Lord, we have to know what was the background of this speech of the Lord. This speech happened before the end of the life, earthly life of the Lord on earth, just before his crucifixion. الحديث ده حصل قبل موت السيد المسيح على الصليب. عشان كده هتلاقوا ده in Mark chapter 13. As you know, book of Mark just 16, number 14, اللي هو crucifixion. فإحنا عندنا this teaching happened, or the Lord gave this teaching just before his crucifixion. He went to the temple in the holy week, in the last week, and he started to preach about the destruction of Jerusalem, the destruction of the temple. So the disciples, all of them, they were troubled. So some of them came privately to the Lord and they asked him, is that true? Is that will happen? Give us signs when that will happen. خلوا بالكوا ان المسيح هنا بيتكلم, he spoke about two things at the same time, about the destruction of Jerusalem and about the end of the world together. ففي الـ في الـ في الـ في الحديث ده المسيح بيتكلم عن حاجتين مع بعض, نهاية العالم ودمار أورشليم. فهي gave them many signs to be sure when he is at the door. شوفوا الرحوله, tell us when these things be, what will be sign when all the things will be fulfilled. Jesus answered, take heed that no one deceives you. Many will come in my name saying I am he. وبعدين قال إيه بقى, you hear of wars, rumors of war, do not trouble. Such things must happen, but the end is not yet. And now we are seeing these signs. What is COVID? Think about the war between Ukraine and between Russia and all what happening all over the world these days in the economic, politics, in everything. This not the end. Nations will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There will be earthquakes, various places. There will be famine, trouble. These are the beginning of sorrows. And we are living these days right now. ده اللي المسيح قاله لنا. عشان كده بقول المسيح معلم أمين. والكنيسة أمينة أن هي by the end of the year بتقول لنا be careful. Many times in the gospel today المسيح بيقول لك إيه, watch out for yourselves. خلي بالك من نفسك. ليه؟ لأن sometimes when we see all the signs we became distracted and focus on what is happening and neglect ourselves. He said be careful. Whenever you see all these things, take heed for yourself. Watch yourself. لأن دي المعظم بيعمل دي، وأنا أول واحد بعمل الغلطة دي، إن الواحد لما بيشوف اللي بيحصل ده يبتدي يركز في اللي بيحصل ويبتدي يقول that is right and that is wrong, what is going on, وإيه اللي بيحصل، وكله بينجلكت إنه يواتش him himself. So the Lord gave us today, he says، شوف النقطة دي، قال حاجة غريبة قوي، brother will betray brother to death and a father he's a child and children will rise up against parents and cause them to be put to death. There will be many divisions, be many troubles, هيبقى في many problems في families, في churches, في the whole world, between countries. But for you, you will be hated by all for my name's sake. But he who endures to the end shall be saved. من يصبر إلى المنتهى هذا يخلص. كلام جميل لكن الوقت قليل. الآية دي أنا مش فاهمها مش عارفها بس عاوزكم تفكروا فيها. The Lord gives something amazing. Do you know he tried to connect between the second destruction of Jerusalem, which happened exactly after the speech of the Lord 30 years after. And he connected between that and between what happened 200 years before at the destruction of Jerusalem, for the second time by Antiochus Epiphanes, and between his second coming. يعني خلوا بالكم من دي. This speech, the Lord said it, maybe at year 30, just 1 week before his crucifixion. And exactly he said, بعد كده شوف بيقول ايه, بيقول لهم ايه. هو كان بيتكلم دلوقتي عن destruction of Jerusalem. فبيقول لهم ايه في الاخر شوفوا. Assuredly I say to you, this generation will by no means pass away till all the things take place. And that's exactly what happened after 30 years. Rome came to Jerusalem and destructed Jerusalem and destructed the temple. ده حصل بالضبط. But the Lord here is connecting what will happen few years later with his second coming and what happened just before 200 years when Antiochus Epiphanes destroyed the temple. He said something amazing, and I just all of us to be aware about this abomination of desolation. So when you see the abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet standing where it ought not, let the reader understand this, let those who are in Judea flee to the mountain. The Lord gave like a sign. He say, be careful. When you see the abomination of desolation, that was the sign of Rome. He said, whenever you see the sign of Rome in the temple, where it shall not be in that place, know that it is at the door. He wants to say, be careful, as Daniel prophesied, that whenever you see the sign of the world in the church, know that it is at the door. Did you get it? دانيال قال ايه؟ خلوا بالكوا ركسة الخراب اللي هي علامة العالم. لو لقيتوا علامة العالم مرفوعة في الهيكل اعرفوا انه على الابواب. فالمسيح ربطها باللي بيحصل اليومين دول. قال لك منين ما تلاقي العالم دخل على الكنيسة اعرف ان هي ايه؟ بتخلص خلاص. متى رأيتم ركسة الخراب في الموضع الذي لا ينبغي ان تكون فيه فاعلموا أنه قريب. اهربوا لنفوسكم. وما أقوله لكم أقوله للجميع. اسهروا. What I am saying to you, I'm saying to all. Watch, watch, watch. Watch to yourself. I am praying that the Lord words and Lord teaching pierce our hearts and it change our mind, change our hearts and to be watchful. Every one of us and to have time to pray and to be enlightened by the knowledge of the Lord and by His words. الواحد دماغه تنور بكلام المسيح ويستعد لأنه قريب على الأبواب. Blessed is the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now forever, unto the age of all ages. Amen.